OK，let's start，我们开始学习吧。今天我们学习第六课。Today we will learn lesson six。我会说汉语。我会说汉语。I can speak Chinese。Today first we will review lesson five, then learn some new knowledge about Chinese 拼音. We will pay special attention to the combination of the first tongue and other tongues. Today, we will also learn some new words and grammars. From this class, we can express what you are able to do, describe the nature or state of somebody or something, and we can ask how to do. Okay, first, let's review the knowledge of lesson 5 through some exercises. The first practice is to choose the right syllable you hear. I will read one of it. Okay, let's start. First one, 前面，前面，前面。Okay, this answer should be A, right? 前面，前面。Okay, next one。凶狠，凶狠，凶狠。The answer，凶狠。Here it should be C，狠，not A. A is 横，but in Chinese we don't have this capital, so C is right. 凶狠。Okay, next。回去，回去，回去。Yes, good. B is right. Okay, next one. 富翁，富翁，富翁，富翁，富翁。翁，啊，it should be C，富翁。OK，next，宣传，宣传，宣传，宣传。Which one is right? Yes, good. A is right. OK。Next practice. This exercise is about how to distinguish between aspirated sound and non-aspirated sound. Please write down the initials you hear. Okay, number one. 保护，保护，保护。It should be which one? Listen again. 保护，it should be 波保护保啊，not unaspirated sound。OK，next，兔子，兔子，兔子，good，t is right，兔子，rabbit，next。重新，重新，重新。Very good. 吃 is right. Next. 情况，情况，情况。Good. 科，况，情况。Next. 口腔，口腔，very good. Next，做梦，做梦，做梦，good. Next，搅拌，搅拌，搅拌，very good. The last one. 放弃，放弃，放弃。Good. 七 is right. Okay, let's look at next practice. This exercise is about syllable dividing mark. Please choose the syllable you hear. The first sentence. 我想穿一件皮袄。我想穿一件皮袄。Good. B is right. Next. 这是一段激昂的旋律。这是一段激昂的旋律。这是一段激昂的旋律。Very good. A is right. Next. 你去过西安吗？你去过西安吗？你去过西安吗？Which one is right? 西安。Yes, A is right. 西安，not 西安。西安。OK。我写了三个方案。我写了三个方案。我写了三个方案。方案，very good. B is right. Okay, next, let's review some new words we learned in last class. Some words are very important, like 几，几，几 is a question word to ask the numbers less than 10. Okay, number one, 这是我们的。Which one is right? Yes, good. 这是我们的家。Number two, 张老师今年。Number two is 张老师。他是老师，so 今年，which one is right? Yes, A is right. 今年多大了？多大了？张老师，老师，so it must be older than 10. Number three，他女儿今年三，good，他女儿今年三岁了，very good。Last one，你家有？Yes, B is right。你家有几口人？几口人啊？几？We use it to ask the number less than 10。多大？We can use it to ask all ages, no matter it's more than 10 or less than 10. Okay, this is the lesson 5. Today we will learn some new knowledge about lesson 6. First, let's learn today's pinyin knowledge. There are four tones in Chinese. Four tones. But when we read a syllable, due to the influence of airflow, the pronunciation of each Chinese character in the syllable will change slightly compared with reading a single Chinese character. So today we will pay special attention to the combination of the first tone and other tones. Please listen. 咖啡，咖啡，公园，公园，机场，机场，车站。车站。Please listen carefully to the third tone in the syllable. When we read it alone, its tone falls first and then rises. 场. But in syllables, it is more similar to a falling tone and the rising tone is not obvious. Listen. 场机场机场 The rising part is not obvious. Okay, let's read. You can read after me. 跟我读。今天今天今年今年精彩精彩车票车票公司公司刚才刚才操场操场鸡蛋鸡蛋刮风刮风欢迎欢迎经理经理机会机会 OK, now let's do a practice. Please choose the syllable you hear. Number one, 关心关心关心 Yes, good. A is right. Number two, 关于关于关于 A or B? Listen again. 关于 Yes, good. B is right. Number three. 开始开始开始 Oh, most of you choose B. Listen again. 开始开始 It's a rising tone or a falling tone. Listen carefully. 开始开始 Yes, A is right. B is 开始开始 But I read 开始开始 So A is right. Okay, last one. 高兴高兴高兴高兴 Yes, good. B is right. 高兴 Okay, now let's do a challenging exercise. Please listen to me and mark the right tone. Mark the right tone. Number one. 中午中午 Good. Third tone. 中午 Next. 加油加油加油加油 It's up or down. 加油油 It should be, yes, second time. 加油 OK, next. 抽烟抽烟 Good.First time, 抽烟 Next, 因为因为 Very good, fourth time. Next, 吃饭吃饭 Very good, fourth time. Next, 花钱花钱花钱 Very good. Second time. Well done. Okay, these are today's pinyin knowledge. Now let's look at next part. Now we will learn the new words and the grammars today. Today's new grammars and words are about what I am able to do, what I am not able to do, and how to do. Let's look at the first word, 说. 说, 说 means speak, to say. 说汉语, speak Chinese. 说英语, speak English. 说汉语, 说英语。他说汉语，我们说英语。他说汉语，我们说英语。He speaks Chinese, we speak English. 对不起，我不说英语。对不起，我不说英语。It means, sorry, I don't speak English. Okay, now let's look at this picture. Let's look at this picture. The girl didn't hear what she was saying. At this time, the girl could say, 对不起，你说什么？对不起，你说什么？你说什么？ It means, what are you talking about?对不起，你说什么？ So in this case, she can answer. 我说，你有汉语名字吗？你有汉语名字吗？ Here, 说 can be used before direct quotation. 我说，你有汉语名字吗？ Okay, next word, 妈妈。妈妈，妈妈，这是什么？这是地图，地图 map. I think in different languages, the word 妈妈 has a similar pronunciation. 妈妈 mother. Okay, let's look at the next word. 会，会 means can or be able to. First, 会。会 is a modal verb, which is used before a verb. Subject plus 会 plus do something. Second, 会 indicates acquiring an ability through learning. Here, please pay attention to this ability is through learning. For example, 我会说汉语。我会说汉语。I can speak Chinese.Speak Chinese, 会说汉语 You should learn Chinese first, then you can speak Chinese. Let's look at these three words. Please read after me first. 打篮球打篮球打篮球 means play basketball. 做饭做饭 It means to cook.跳舞跳舞 to dance. Okay, of the three things, which can you do? If you can play basketball, in this case, we can use 会 to make a sentence. For example, 我会打篮球我会打篮球我会做饭我会做饭，我会跳舞，我会跳舞。你会做饭 ，very good。我会做饭 ，good。我会跳舞啊，你会跳舞 ，very good。Let's look at this question。你会说汉语吗？你会说汉语吗？We learned ma, we put it at the end of a sentence to ask yes or no. This question, 你会说汉语吗? If the answer is yes, how to answer it? We can say, 我会说汉语。我会说一点汉语。Very good. 我会说汉语。But if you never learned Chinese before, so in this case, we should say, 我 good. 我不会说汉语。We learned 不, we put 不 before a verb to give a negative form.我不会说汉语。So we can put 不 before 会 to give a negative form. Okay, this is a dialogue. Let's listen to this conversation.
你会说汉语吗？
我会说汉语。
你妈妈会说汉语吗？
她不会说。
Okay, let's listen again.
你会说汉语吗？
我会说汉语。
你妈妈会说汉语吗？
她不会说。
Good. Can you tell me what are they talking about?Can you tell me what are they talking about? According to this dialogue, what are they talking about? They are talking about speak Chinese, right? So they say, Can you speak? 你会说汉语吗? Right?你会说汉语吗？我会说汉语。And he also asked her mother, right? 你妈妈会说汉语吗？ Yes, 你妈妈会说汉语吗？她不会说。They are talking about 会说汉语 or 不会说汉语。Now let's look at this sentence. 你妈妈会说汉语吗？ Okay, let's think about it.Can we use some other sentence to replace it? Some grammars we learned. See, A asked B, 你会说汉语吗? And here, A asked the same question about her mother. So can we use some grammars we learned before? A repeated the same question, 会说汉语. Do you remember which grammar we learned before? About...To ask the same question we mentioned previously. Remember it? This part. 你妈妈会说汉语吗? We can also say, 你妈妈呢?你妈妈呢? Yes, very good. 你妈妈呢? A is asking her mother. 你妈妈呢? So we can use 呢 this grammar. Because A asked the same question.会说汉语 right? Very good. Let's do a practice. According to the picture and question, can you answer this question? 你会打篮球吗? Let's answer it. 你会打篮球吗? How to answer it? Have a try. 你会打篮球吗? So if the answer is yes, we can say,Very good. I already saw two good answers. Very good. Now we have two different situations. 你会打篮球吗?我会打篮球。If you cannot, you can say, 我不会打篮球。But in a conversation, A and B, they both know what are they talking about. So in this case, we can just say, 我会 or 我不会 in short.Okay, let's look at this conversation. 你会开车吗?你会开车吗? Let's answer it. 你会开车,开车 remember, 开车 means to drive, right? 开车 to drive. Good, 我会开车. Very good, 我不会,我不会, good. See, 你会开车吗?我会开车 or you can just say 我会 If you cannot, you can say 我不会开车 or just say 我不会。Very good. Let's look at these four pictures. These are typical Chinese cuisine. Chinese cuisine, it is 菜菜 dish cuisine 中国菜中国菜 Chinese cuisine or Chinese food. Have you ever eaten Chinese food? Have you ever eaten it or tried some Chinese food? 做啊，做 means to do, to make or produce. 做啊 ，yes, yeah, delicious. I think so. Okay, 做 Let's look at this word. 做菜，做菜 means to cook. 你会做菜吗？你会做菜吗 ？Can you? Let's have a try. 你会做菜吗 ？Let's answer it. We can say.你会做中国菜吗？啊，我不会。你会做中国菜吗？嗯，你哦、oh, ，very good 你。我会 ，good。你会做中国菜 ？You can also say 我不会做中国菜。你会做中国菜吗？我会做啊，我会做乌克兰菜 ，very good。我会做。好 ，let's look at this question。你会做什么菜？你会做什么菜 ？What does it mean? 做什么菜 ？We learned 什么 before? 什么 means what, right? 你会做什么菜 ？It means what can you cook? 你会做什么菜 ？You can answer it. 我会做西红柿炒鸡蛋。Do you know 西红柿炒鸡蛋？西红柿炒鸡蛋啊，西红柿炒鸡蛋 ，it means scrambled eggs with tomatoes. It is a very common but famous Chinese dish. Almost every family can make this simple dish. And 西红柿炒鸡蛋 ，it tastes sweet and sour, which is very popular. 西红柿炒鸡蛋 ，you can have a try.Okay, let's look at this word. 好吃，好吃。Can you tell me what 好 means? 好 means good, right? 吃 Do you remember what that means? 吃，吃 means to eat. 好吃 good to eat. Let's combine their meaning together. So 好吃 it means tasty, delicious.好吃 Yes, yummy. Okay, let's look at this. 这个好吃吗 Let's look at this picture. 这个好吃吗 How to answer it? 这个好吃吗、If you like it, you can say 嗯，好吃 If you don't like it, you can say 不好吃、Remember, 不 means not.We can put it before verb or adjective. 不好吃。Do you know what is? 这是什么？这是什么？ Oh, you know it. 这是包子。Yes, very good. 包子啊、steamed stuffed bun. 包子 It can be filled with meat or vegetables. 包子啊，这个好吃吗？ Have you ever tried it? 这个好吃吗？ If you like it, you can say 好吃。If you don't like it, we can give a negative form. 不好吃，不好吃。Okay, let's look at this question. 中国菜好吃吗？中国菜好吃吗 ？You can answer 好吃，好吃。If you really like it, so 好吃 is not enough.So 好吃 is not enough to express you like it. So we can use an adverb before 好吃。很很很 is an adverb. It means very, very. 很很好吃很好吃 It means very delicious. Yes, we can also use 太好吃了。 Okay, let's look at these four words. 好 means good. 很好 very good, great. 好吃 delicious. 很好吃 very delicious. 好 do you remember 好 what's its negative form? 好 we can say 不好 right? And 好吃 how to say not delicious?不好吃 right? 不好不好吃 But if you want to express very bad or very not delicious, so in that case, we can put 很 before 不好很不好很不好 or 很不好吃很不好吃 Here, 很不好Its negative mood is stronger than 不好 This is what we will learn the sentence with an adjective predicate. When using an adjective to describe the nature or state of someone or something, an adverb of degree should be used. 很, very, quite is one of adverbs of degree. For example, 中国菜好吃 is not a sentence. If we want to make a sentence, we should say 中国菜很好吃中国菜很好吃 Here, 很 is necessary. Subject, 很 adjective. Let's look at this sentence. 中国菜是好吃 This sentence sounds like a directit sounds like a direct translation from English, but there is no such expression in Chinese. So, in the affirmative form of adjective predicate sentence, we must use degree adverb instead of 是. Here, we cannot use 是, we must use degree adverb. Let's look at this question. 中国菜好吃吗?中国菜很好吃 or you can say 中国菜不好吃 Subject 不 Adjective It's a negative form 中国菜很不好吃 Next 你的汉语好吗你的汉语好吗 How to answer it? You can use negative form You can also use affirmative form你的汉语好吗? Let's answer it. You can say, 我的汉语很好。我的汉语很好。我的汉语很好。Very good. But if you want to give a negative form, we can use 不。我的汉语不好。我的汉语不好。I should still work hard. 我的汉语不好。我的汉语很不好。我的汉语很不好。Okay, let's do a practice. Do you know what's this? 这是什么？这是什么？In Spring Festival, the North China's people they like to eat it. 对，饺子，饺子啊。Here is a question. 饺子好吃吗？饺子好吃吗? A. 饺子好吃 B. 饺子很好吃 Which answer is right? Which one is better? Which one is better? Yes, B is better. 饺子很好吃 When we use an adjective predicate sentence, here 很 is necessary. Let's look at this.你妈妈的汉语好吗？你妈妈的汉语好吗 ？A. 我妈妈的汉语不好。B. 我妈妈的汉语很不好。A and B. They both are right. Both are right. 我妈妈的汉语不好。我妈妈的汉语很不好。Both are right. Okay.Now, let's listen to the dialogue and please judge these two sentences. If they are true or false, 中国菜很好吃，我会做中国菜。True or false? Please listen.
中国菜好吃吗？
中国菜很好吃。
你会做中国菜吗？
我不会做。
Okay, can you tell me the answer? 中国菜很好吃。It's true or false? It's true. Or you need to listen once again? Okay, let's listen once again.
中国菜好吃吗？
中国菜很好吃。
你会做中国菜吗？
我不会做。
Okay, the first sentence, 中国菜很好吃 is true or false? Yes, it's true. The second one, 我会做中国菜 is true or false? 我会做中国菜 Very good. 第一个是对的，我中国菜很好吃，对的。我会做中国菜，错的。Okay, let's look at this conversation. Please read after me. 中国菜好吃吗？中国菜很好吃。你会做中国菜吗？我不会做。Very good. Let's look at this picture.What is she doing? What is she doing? She is writing something, right? So how to say write? In Chinese, we use 写写写 means to write. 汉字汉字 Chinese character. 这是汉字这是汉字这不是汉字，这不是汉字。写汉字，写汉字 means to write characters. 写汉字，我会写汉字，我会写汉字。你会写汉字吗？你会写汉字吗？我不会写汉字。啊，我会 good， 我不会写汉字啊。哦，你们都会写汉字 ，very good。好，我会写汉字。OK， 汉字 we can also say 字 in short， just say 字 ，it means Chinese character。这个，这个，这个 it means this。这个汉字。这个汉字 means this Chinese character. 这个汉字，你会写这个汉字吗？你会写这个汉字吗？这个汉字 it looks a little bit complicated. So 你会写这个汉字吗？你会写这个汉字吗？啊，我不会写 very good. 我不会写，我不会写这个汉字。对 difficult 好 next word 读读读 means to read 你会读这个汉字吗你会读这个汉字吗我不会读这个汉字我不会读这个字好 now I can tell you the pronunciation we can say这个字读棒这个字读棒棒 is its 拼音棒棒 means awesome, excellent, 棒这个字读棒你会读你朋友的汉语名字吗你会读你朋友的汉语名字吗我们有汉语名字，你会读你的汉语名字吗？ 读汉语名字。 OK, let's look at this word. 怎么怎么怎么 it means how. We can say 怎么 plus 写，怎么写。 What does it mean? 怎么写 it means how to write. 怎么写 how to write.怎么 plus 读 What does it mean? 是什么意思？怎么 plus 读？怎么读？怎么读？ So 怎么读 it means how to read. 怎么读？ How to read. Okay, if you only know 拼音 but you don't know its characters, you can ask 这个汉字怎么写？棒棒，这个汉字怎么写？这个是棒。 If you only know Chinese characters but you don't know 拼音， you can ask 这个汉字怎么读？这个汉字怎么读？这个汉字读棒，这个汉字读棒。Okay, we can use subject, 怎么 do something, to ask how to do something, how to do something. Let's look at some sentences. First one, 这个汉字怎么读? How to read this character? 这个汉字怎么读? 你的名字怎么写? 你的名字怎么写? What does that mean?你的名字怎么写? It means how to write your name, right? 你的名字怎么写? 这个菜怎么做? 这个菜怎么做? What does that mean? Can you understand it? 这个菜怎么做? It means how to cook this dish, right? 这个菜怎么做? Yes, very good. How to cook this meal.Okay, now please listen to a dialogue and judge these two sentences. They are true or false.
你会写汉字吗？
我会写。
这个字怎么写？
对不起，这个字我会读，不会写。
Okay, now let's listen once again.
你会写汉字吗？
我会写。
你会写汉字吗？
我会写。
这个字怎么写？
对不起，这个字我会读，不会写。
Okay.我不会写汉字，对还是错 ？True or false？ 我不会写汉字 ，false。True， two different answers。我不会写汉字 ，true or false？ you have false， true， 错错对对，Okay， let's listen again。
你会写汉字吗？
我会写。
这个字怎么写？
对不起，这个字我会读，不会写。
Will you change your answer? 我不会写汉字，对还是错 ？True or false? Yes, very good. It's false. False.好 second one, 我会读这个汉字，对吗？我会读这个汉字。Yes, very good. 对的。It's true. Okay, please read after me. 你会写汉字吗？你会写汉字吗？我会写。我会写。See, B answers.我会写 这个字怎么写？这个字怎么写？对不起，这个字我会读，不会写。对不起，这个字我会读，不会写。See, B says 不会写 ，but B just 不会写这个字。Only this character, 这个字不会写。Okay, very good. These are main content of today's class. Now let's do some practice. Before that, let's review what we learned today. These are new words we learned today. Please read after me. 会说妈妈菜很好吃做写汉字字怎么读 Okay, can you read them without 拼音? Let's have a try. 会说妈妈菜很好吃做写汉字字怎么读 Okay, very good. Now let's do this practice.I give you 1 minute, I think that's enough to read the sentence. Choose the proper word. Okay, are you ready? 准备好了吗? Okay, let's look at the first one. 我会写我的汉语名字。Very good.E, 我不会写我的汉语名字。Next, 你做中国菜吗？你做中国菜吗 ？Good, B is right. 你会做中国菜吗 ？Next, 我朋友会说汉语，他的汉语 ，Good, A is right.他的汉语很好。Next, 老师，这个汉字。Yes, very good. 老师，这个汉字怎么读？这个汉字怎么读 ？OK, next. Are you ready?你的中国朋友会做中国菜，会做中国菜。哦 ，G. I think it should be F. 你的中国朋友会做中国菜吗？然后 we should choose F. Let's look at this sentence. 你的中国朋友会做中国菜吗 ？This sentence is ask yes or no. 会 or不会 So in this case, we should use 吗 Next sentence. 我会说汉语你 Yes, this one we should choose. 你呢 Now, this sentence we should use 呢 to ask about the same situation. And you, how about you? 我会说汉语你呢 Okay, next one. 我妈妈朋友会说汉语。Good. 的，我妈妈的朋友会说汉语。OK, the last one. 你朋友是 Yes, good. 你朋友是哪国人？哪 means which 啊，which country？你朋友是哪国人？OK, let's look at this practice. Choose the right answers. OK, I give you 1 to 2 minutes. 嘿，Are you ready？准备好了吗？写好了吗？OK，let's read together，我们一起读啊。你妈妈会做中国菜吗？会做中国菜吗？Yes, good. We should choose E。他不会做，他不会做啊，这是妈妈，妈妈啊，female，他不会做，他不会做。Next，这个汉字怎么写？这个汉字怎么写？Very good，A is right。对不起，这个汉字我会读，不会写。Next，李老师会说汉语吗？李老师会说汉语吗？Good. B is right. 会。李老师是中国人，他会说汉语啊，会。Next，你会写汉字吗？你会写汉字吗？Good. D is right. 我会说汉语，不会写汉字。The last one，中国菜好吃吗？Yes. C is right. 中国菜很好吃。OK，next one, please put the words into a sentence. You can type the words or just type the numbers. Very good，我朋友会说汉语，我朋友会说汉语。OK，next one。这个 means this 啊，这个。Very good，这个菜很好吃，这个菜很好吃。OK，next one。Think about 怎么？怎么？It means how？怎么 plus verb？怎么 do something？Yes, very good. We should use 你的名字怎么写？你的名字怎么写？OK，next one。It's a little bit difficult. Maybe there are two answers. Very good. 我不会读这个字. As I saw a different answer. Good. We have two ways to make this sentence. 我不会读这个字。You can also say, 这个字我不会读。Both are right. Okay, next practice, is correction. The, it's not correction. This sentence, please choose the right position of 很. Choose the right position of 很. We should put 很 at A, B, or C. Which one is right? Yes, good. 我们的汉语很好。我们的汉语很好。We should put 很 before adjective. This one? This 个菜不好吃。So we should put 很 C? Can we put 很 after the adjective? No, we should choose B. 这个菜很不好吃。很不好吃。It's a very strong negative mood. 好 ,this one. 不 ,where should we put 不?他会读这个汉字。The negative form should be very good. 他不会读这个汉字。他不会读这个汉字。Okay, the last one. 怎么 ?Where should we put 怎么?Good, 很好啊。B is right. 啊，我们应该选择 B. 中国菜怎么做?中国菜怎么做? Very good. Well done. Did very well. Okay, so much for today. Time flies. We have finished today's lesson. And next time, we will review lesson 6 and learn some new knowledge in lesson 7. From next class, we can express the age, time, and date by sentence. And we will also learn some new knowledge about Chinese pinyin.Okay, so much for today. You can download this Chinese class for more conversation, for more, courses about HSK. Okay, do you have any questions about today's class? You can ask me now if you have any questions about today's class. Download, you want to download what? You want to download the video or something? 没有问题。Okay, if you don't have any questions, see you next week. The app, you can scan this QR code to download the app in Chinese Plus. You can scan this. 不客气，再见。